Good evening, parents, grandparents, family and friends, special guests, and graduates. Welcome to the commencement exercises for the Chaminade Julien Catholic High School Class of 2021. On behalf of our faculty and staff, the Board of Trustees, and the sisters, brothers, and priests of our founding orders, the Sisters of Notre Dame de Namur and the Society of Mary, I thank you for joining us this evening. I ask as we begin today's celebration that you respect the importance of this event by muting your mobile phone or anything that might make noise and disturb our speakers and presenters. If you must accept a phone call, please exit to the lobby. Your seat will be waiting for you when you get back. Thank you. Class of 2021 and your families, you made it. Live and in person, you made it to this historic event. We are so grateful to the University of Dayton and the staff of the arena for their effort to make tonight possible for all of us. After more than a year of distance, inconveniences, sadness, struggles, and many grace-filled moments, you, the members of the class of 2021, have persevered and you've flourished, and you're ready to move boldly forward towards God's call for each of you. Perhaps this year more than ever, our celebration tonight with the members of this class represents the results of hard work, determination, struggles, fears, tears, laughs, late nights, early mornings, and maybe most importantly, many, many prayers. God has called each member of the class of 2021 for a special purpose, and these young men and women have spent time preparing to go to make God's goodness known in every age and everywhere. Therefore, it is fitting that we begin our celebration as we do each day at Chaminade Julien with a prayer. Daniel Nassif, a member of FLIGHT and president of the National Honor Society, will lead us in prayer. Daniel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. As we gather here tonight, we pray for all members of the Chaminade Julien Class of 2021. We thank you, our good God, for all we have experienced these past 4 years. Years filled with laughter, accomplishment, happiness, disappointments, growth, and grace. We thank you, God, for blessing us with loving families who have supported us throughout our lives and made sacrifices for us to be a part of the Chaminade Julien community. We thank you for the gifts and talents you have given to each member of the class, which we have discovered and developed and used in the classroom, on stage, in the gym, the pool, or on the field, and, most importantly, in service to your people. Seated here tonight, as we prepare to move into the next stage of our lives, we pray for guidance for each of us. We pray that we will always sense your holy presence in our lives. We pray that we will always know you are with us, even when things might seem most difficult. And we pray that no matter where life takes us, we will remember that Chaminade Julien will always be our home. We ask this through your Son, Jesus, our Lord and Savior, and through the intercession of St. Julie Billiard and Blessed William Joseph Chaminade. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
It is our tradition at Chaminade Julien that the graduates who give the welcoming address and the farewell address are chosen by their classmates and their teachers, not only for who they are, but for what they have to say as a class. Claire Leingang, who served this year as senior class president, has been selected to give the welcoming address. Claire.
Good evening, class of 2021. We made it. It is my privilege and my honor to welcome you all to the graduation ceremony for the Chaminade Julien class of 2021. Parents, family, friends, teachers and staff, mentors and loved ones, we are gathered here today to celebrate the perseverance, the dedication, the strength, and the accomplishments of this class of soon-to-be graduates. This year was a year like no other. The COVID-19 pandemic ravaged our world and forced us into a new mode of learning. Threats of violence increased tenfold throughout our nation and even in our own school community. Our holiday celebrations were confined to Zoom calls and FaceTime, and our supply of toilet paper ran dry. Pajama pants became our new uniform, and on bad hair days, we simply turned our cameras off. Pies showed up on our doorsteps, and homework for Senora's class arrived in my mailbox every week. During quarantine, Tiger King and the daily COVID numbers captivated our world, and most notably, the mullet made its triumphant return. Yet, despite the unending changes that came our way, this class, the class of 2021, persevered. We quickly adjusted to our new virtual world, ending our junior year at home and separated from our school community. As the fall of 2020 rolled around, we came back to school in person, armed with masks and hand sanitizer, determined to make the most of our senior year. Yes, there were disappointments and senior activities that were impossible to make happen due to the mask mandate and social distancing measures. However, this class remained optimistic through it all. We remained steadfast in hope for the day in which we could all be gathered together under one roof in imitation of a normal year. My friends, that day is today. Our hope, our dedication to making this day happen through our commitment to wearing masks and maintaining physical distance, and most importantly, our trust in the Lord that He would bring us out of the darkness and into the light of His grace, has brought us to this very moment. As He always does for us, our God has provided us with this day, this opportunity to celebrate not only our academic and athletic achievements, but also our devotion to service, our caring and compassionate hearts, our characters, our patience, and our endurance. Class of 2021, we have so much to be proud of and to celebrate tonight. Amidst a global pandemic, our class created and implemented capstone projects, tackling numerous social justice issues, making an impact on our school community, the greater Dayton community, and even the world, and reflecting the light and love of Sister Dorothy Stang in all of our work. Our class has volunteered countless hours of service to organizations in and beyond Dayton, demonstrating our profound commitment to being people of service and contributing members of society. Our dedication to being lifelong learners is evident in our academic accomplishments, our involvement in extracurriculars, athletics, and leadership roles, and the scholarships we've received, which are listed in the graduation programs. These values have made us immensely prepared to begin this new chapter in our lives, venturing out to begin our careers, enter into the service, or further our education in universities throughout the nation. My fellow classmates, we entered into the halls of Chaminade Julien in August of 2017 as the largest freshman class that this school had seen for many years. In those early days of our freshman year, we began timidly forming friendships, amazed by how many new faces we saw and our classmates from so many different grade schools and zip codes. Today, we stand more united than ever to celebrate each other's accomplishments, to rejoice in the memories we have made over the last 4 years, and to wish each other well in our next steps as we take what we have learned throughout our time as Eagles and use it to set the world on fire. My friends, tonight is our night. To everyone who has gathered here tonight to join us in our celebration, thank you. We are so blessed to be joined by so many friends, family, and loved ones for this joyous occasion. My fellow classmates, thank you all for the contributions you have made that have made this graduating class of seniors the best one that CJ has ever seen. I invite everyone here tonight to join me in celebrating and congratulating this incredible class and the amazing classmates that I have had the pleasure of calling friends these last 4 years. Seniors, sit back, relax, and enjoy this moment, this night, and this celebration of each and every one of you. Our hard work, our dedication, our patience, and our endurance have made us ever so deserving of this celebration. Congratulations, class of 2021. God bless and go Eagles.
Chaminade Julianne is an educational community of faith, creating and fostering authentic community and educating for family spirit are essential elements of our mission to provide an exceptional Catholic education in the tradition of the Sisters of Notre Dame de Namur and the Marianists. Thus, it's important for us to recognize special demonstrations of the way in which our mission is realized each year. First, we begin by recognizing the families of our graduates. If you are a parent or a grandparent of one of these students, please stand. If you are a brother or a sister, please stand. If you help provide the financial resources that made Chaminade Julianne possible, please stand. The class of 2021 wants to thank you. Academic excellence, commitment to faith development, and service to others is fostered by outstanding educators who serve our students with conviction and passion. I ask our teachers and staff members to stand together and be recognized for all you have done during this exceptional year in partnership with parents in the Ministry of Catholic Education at Chaminade Julianne. As Claire mentioned, the class of 2021 is truly an exceptional class with many accomplishments. The list of scholarships that she mentioned, which you see in the program, provides some evidence that these almost graduates are very special. Let me highlight a few other examples. 168 members of the class of 2021 are heading all over the country this fall and will attend 53 different colleges and universities. 86 members, 48% of the class, have been awarded scholarships to date with a total value in excess of $17 million. Six members of this class will serve in the United States military, either as an enlisted service person, a cadet in one of the service academies, or a participant in the Reserve Officer Training Corps at their college or university. Fifty-six graduates from the class of 2021 are members of the National Honor Society. Induction into the National Honor Society is based on scholarship, leadership, service, and character. These students are wearing honor medals and are listed in your program. Would these students please stand now and be recognized? Seventy-eight members of the class are graduating with distinction because of their qualified weighted grade point average during their high school years. These students are wearing an honors pin tonight to symbolize their sustained effort. Students with a bronze pin are graduating with a weighted GPA of 3.75 to 3.99 and have achieved the distinction of cum laude. Would these students please stand and be recognized? Students with a silver pin have earned a weighted GPA of 4.0 to 4.24 and have earned the distinction of magna cum laude. Please stand and be recognized. Students with a gold pin have a weighted GPA of 4.25 or higher, having earned the distinction of summa cum laude. Please stand now and be recognized. Students who achieve top scores in the annual PSAT may receive recognition from the National Merit Scholarship Corporation. The top 3 to 4% of scores are named commended students, and the top 1%, representing less than 15,000 students across the nation, are named finalists. In the class of 2021, one student was recognized as a commended student and one as a finalist. Commended student John Rains and finalist Catherine Shineman, please stand and be recognized. At Chaminade Julianne, there are two student groups that work in partnership with teachers and administrators to strengthen the CJ experience. Members of Student Council plan and execute events and activities that promote community and school spirit. The members of Student in Action bring creativity and diversity to work for the betterment of the CJ community. There are 31 students in this class of 2021 who served as class officer or student ambassador or a member of the social committee or spirit committee. And there are 9 members of the class who led the efforts of Students in Action. Would all of these seniors please stand and be recognized? The Eagle Ambassadors are a committed group of students who, as young as sophomores, answered the call to be caretakers of our mission. Prior to the start of the pandemic, students spent hours each year guiding and welcoming visitors and prospective students to our community. This year, they've reached out to prospective students and families remotely, but they have continued to represent CJ with authenticity. Their work has helped to ensure CJ's standing as one of the leaders for Catholic education. There are 75 graduating seniors who served as an Eagle Ambassador. I now ask these students to stand and be recognized. The class of 2021, during their 4 years at Chaminade Julianne, provided 9,953 hours of community service over and above their requirements. Based on information from the Independent Sector, a leading resource for nonprofit organizations, an hour of service can be valued at $28.54. Therefore, the class of 2021 has provided more than $284,000 of services to agencies in our community. There are 29 students whose total service hours over 4 years exceeded 100 total hours. Would these students please stand and be recognized? Many members of the class have given of their time and their hearts, acting as faith leaders for their classmates and all CJ students. The members of FLIGHT, Faith Leaders in God's Hands Today, plan our liturgies and lead student service projects. The leaders of Marianist Life encourage students to share their faith and build community with one another. Leaders for Kairos and Junior Retreats share their stories and their own faith journey and encourage their fellow students to more deeply embrace the call to be disciples of Jesus Christ. Would the members of FLIGHT, our Marianist Life leaders, and our Kairos and Junior Retreat leaders please stand now and be recognized? Claire mentioned the success of Senior Capstone. The class of 2021 completed projects successfully, demonstrating in a variety of ways how they have become servant leaders working for justice in our world. Today, we recognize 16 groups who researched and designed projects that earned them the honor of passing with distinction. These projects demonstrated quality research and launched projects that were exceptional in their design and implementation. Would those capstone groups who received a passing with distinction please stand now and be recognized? I ask Mr. Muller, CJ's principal, to help with these final three awards. Each year, the faculty and staff of Chaminade Julianne recognize three seniors who best exemplify the three elements of the school's mission: commitment to faith, dedication to learning, and demonstration of school and family spirit. The Founders Award is given to a student who each day demonstrates the spirit of St. Julie Billiard and Blessed William Joseph Chaminade, whose likenesses you see behind me on stage. The Michael D. Trainer Award, named in honor of CJ's principal from 1999 to 2004, is given to a student who has regularly demonstrated intellectual curiosity. The Gerard Fuzzy Faust Award, named for CJ's legendary coach and teacher from 1933 to 1980, is given to a student who best exemplifies the special Chaminade Julianne Eagle spirit. For the class of 2021, the following students were selected for these three special awards and recognized at our honors assembly last week. I'd like these three students to come to the stage and receive your recognition from Mr. Muller. Fuzzy Faust Award, Max Cross. The Michael Trainer Award, Keely Kosher. And the Founders Award, Michaela Jetty. The class of 2021 has also added to the vibrancy and excitement of the school's performing arts program. Members of the concert band, concert choir, ensembles, and liturgical choir continue to delight virtual and in-person audiences this year, culminating with the Pops concert on May 7th at the Levitt Pavilion downtown. In many ways, members of the class of 2021 are very creative, winning awards for their artwork and their writing and their involvement in music and dance outside of CJ. This year's class song is The Climb, arranged by Anna and Natalie Musson Phillips, and filmed by Carolyn Marshall. Our performers are Michaela Jetty, Anna Musson Phillips, Natalie Musson Phillips, Mac Witherspoon, and Lily Davis. Enjoy.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never. I'm taking
Now the moment that our students have been working for and our parents and family members have been praying to arrive. In just a moment, I'll ask Mr. Moeller, our principal, to come to the podium to present the 2021 candidates for graduation. Mr. Moeller will call each graduate forward one by one. We know that family members want to applaud and share some other modest form of greeting as their graduate comes forward to receive his or her diploma. It's a big night, and each student has accomplished something special. So we invite you to cheer, if you want, when your graduate's name is called. All we ask is that you keep it brief, since we have a lot of students to present tonight. Also, by keeping your cheering brief, you will make sure that the next student's name can be heard loudly and clearly. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, CJ's principal, Mr. Moeller.
Good evening. I am proud to present to you the class of 2021. Ashley Alanis Anguiano. Harley and Alicia Allen. Julian Gutierrez Alvarez. Mia Renee Andrews Pope. Brock Ethan Angel. William Lewis Armstrong. Landon Thomas Avila. Logan Lewis Avila. Jayla Brianna Bailey. Catherine Nicole Baird. Jason Allen Baldwin II. Lauren Olivia Banks. Erica Margaret Barbacho Arpi. Jonathan Charles Barber. Allison Elizabeth Bardine. Allison Elizabeth Berkey. Noah Riley Boehringer. Samuel Allen Boudinot. Amaya Resha Brantley. Nicholas James Braun. William Henry Brodnick. Logan Matthew Brown. Mia Noel Brown. Jessica May Brunner. Emma Marie Burkett. Kennedy Lillian Bird. Benjamin Lee Campion. Jose Enrique Cardenas. Jacob Miguel Casas. Eric Cervantes. Kamara Joyce Ann Chance. Ayana Shaylin Clemens. Brooklyn Grace Marie Cox. Pasquale I. Cristiano. Michael Lawrence Cross. Robert Cornelius Culpepper. Lily McKenna Davis. Sophia Amy Davis. Grace Ellison Delaney. Anna Elizabeth DeLucia. Logan Alexander Downey. Evelyn Rose Durkin. Alan Thomas Eads. Matthew Scott Eifert. Chiamaka Constance Ejinaka. Monica Therese Emery. Maria Rose Emmerich. Patricia Isabel Estrada Sanchez. Colin Joseph Feller. Riley Renee Fertelman. Dominic Trent Fisher. Brandy Lee Foster. Bryce Michael Foster. Abigail Grace Fox. Madeline Grace Frazier. David Keith Frederick Jr. Nina Angeline Fatima Gabriel. Natalie Paige Geyer. Trey Anthony Ganius. Jackson Edward Allen Gatego. Bethlehem Gebrewitz. Lorian Hirgua Gisigo. Orlando Gomez. Cyrus McKinley Evans Good. Mary Elizabeth Grady. Tariana Lachey Green. Jaden Smith Gregory. Lauren Elaine Grohl. Lyle Wesley Gross. Benjamin Eric Hanlon. Jordan Elise Herring. Claire Josephine Hickey. Anna Elise Hyatt. Isaiah Neville Hobbs. Trinity Nicole Howard. Michaela Susan Jetty. Alyssa Taylor Jones. Carrie Mora Cadle. Aiden James Kelly. Nolan Wesley Kimball. Emily Rose Kintz. Keely Callista Kosher. Andrew Ryan Cutter. Lee Michael Langendurfer. Ian Michael Larson. Andrew Jacob Lehman. Megan Kathleen Lerder. Claire Elizabeth Linegang. Fredriana Pearl Littlejohn. Stella Rose Lucas. Suzanne Constance Lyons. Miyakel Francis Malo. Carolyn Elizabeth Marshall. Benjamin Michael Mattill. Marajina Ogechi Emba. Morgan Larray McDaniel. Ava Louise Mendenhall. Riley Aaron Meserve. Eric Stewart Meyer. Zachary James Miller. Muhammad Ali. Jack Carney Monaghan. Yendi Noemi Morales. Emma Noelle Morris. Anna Marguerite Musson Phillips. Natalie Irene Musson Phillips. Kaylee Alexandra Myers. Joseph Isaiah Narker. Daniel Alexander Nassif. Brian Christopher Nabrugi Andreu. Jerome Nine Jumashua. Matthew Allen Noble. Ashton Deshaun Passmore. Leah Manakshi Elizabeth Patel. Sean Frederick Porras. Chloe Marie Prophet. William Francis Radacci. John Scott Rains. Christopher David Rao. Mackenzie Duden Reed. Maya Jennifer Reynolds. Madeline Elizabeth Richardson. Kelsey Morgan Roach. Natalie Mia Rossi. Lauren Elizabeth Sass. Benjamin Garrett Saunders. Jordan Ryan Scheit. Catherine Ann Shineman. Noah Michael Schindler. Gabrielle Aaron Schneider. Clayton Michael Schomer. Maria Rose Shade. Sheldon Neru Shells. Dylan Shane Shoemaker. Ada Kathleen Shuttleworth. Aaron Matthew Seibert. Karis Barbara May Scrobot. Terrence Joseph Slayball. Aaliyah Rianne Nicole Smith. Anthony Cole Solomon. Olivia Claire Starnes. Jeremiah Tahan Tanksley. Aji Renee Tanner Lee. Amanda Lee Jean Taylor. McKenna Marie Taylor. Emma May Timmons. Alexander Stephen Tomczak. Natalie Elizabeth Townsend. Lauren Olivia Turner. Jalil M. Twitty. Erica Alexandra Velicella. Anna Bell Vo. Danielle Marie Walusius. Jason Bernard Ward. McQuiggan O'Malley Weatherspoon. Claire Elizabeth Weaver. Rebecca Elizabeth Wynell. George Turner West. Charles Lee Westbrook. Mia Destiny Whistler. Mark Anthony White. Mason James Wilkson. Isaiah Mitchell Williams. Karan Amir Wood. Dylan Andrew Wurst. Spencer Hawkins Yates. Alexandra Caitlin Younger. Ruben Christopher Zelina. Seniors, please stand. In accordance with the requirements of the State of Ohio and the Archdiocese of Cincinnati, and with the consent of the faculty, trustees, the Marianist, and the Sisters of Notre Dame, Dana Muir, I hereby confer diplomas to the graduates of the Chaminade Julienne Catholic High School, class of 2021. Please be seated.
The student chosen to give the farewell address tonight is the sixth member of the fourth generation of her family to graduate from Chaminade Julienne or one of its predecessor schools. And as her uncle and a member of the third generation of her family, I am so proud to introduce Maya Reynolds.
Hi. 4 years ago, I sat in this arena, watching as my sister graduated with her class, the class of 2017. I imagine myself in this cap and gown, and it's surreal to think that I'm finally here. We, the class of 2021, have finally made it to our graduation night, and now it's time to think back to what brought us here. So let's start with freshman year. Awkward squeaks filled the halls on freshman orientation as we all broke in our new shoes that our moms wouldn't let us wear until the first day because they were, quote, school shoes only. We walked through the halls with little to no confidence because why exactly are there two third floors? We rolled our eyes as the upperclassmen tried to convince us that a pool was settled in between the two floors. And although we weren't gullible enough to believe them, we still went to the second, third floor to get to our English class. Let's just say our minds were filled with silly directions and new places, like the weird printer room on the third floor that can barely fit one person, and how we found ourselves avoiding the second floor boys' bathroom at all costs because the door swung open so quickly that we had absolutely no time to stop before we ran into it. As we complained about the sudden change of having 4 hours of homework a night, Mr. Ricciuto kept us on our toes. He constantly reminded us that high school would only get harder from here. My most memorable time in his class was when we toured different parts of downtown Dayton. We were so excited to leave our classroom and get a break from the rapid note-taking and quizzing. As we stepped out of 505 South Ludlow Street and went a few blocks down, the sight was brand new for some of my classmates. Some people had never really walked downtown, and I, living in the Oregon District, was surprised that going to CJ was their only interaction with the quirks of downtown Dayton. One thing that makes CJ unique is how we come from so many different neighborhoods. A CJ student visiting their friends could go from Vandalia down to Miamisburg, over to Beaver Creek, and up to Huber Heights. The various places that we come from are what makes CJ interesting, because imagine if we were all from the Oregon District or the new downtown apartments. Our perspectives on the world would be the same. We may not have had the same knowledge about places like Bill's, Jim's, or how the Chipotle on Miller Lane is the best one. What makes CJ, CJ, is that we all carry different perspectives, passions, dreams, goals, and stories. And at 8 a.m. every morning, they all exist together. The definition of the word differences, a point or way in which people or things are not the same. But nowhere in this definition does it say that differences separate us. In fact, at CJ, we've experienced differences bringing us together in the ways that we learn from each other and listen to each other. If we were all merely the same, the world would be a boring place. We would have nothing unique to share with others. So we must realize that differences are what spark our curiosity, motivate our aspirations, and make our lives worth living. So we brought into our sophomore year new friendships and even more curiosity. While sophomore year was our last completely normal year, I wouldn't exactly use the word normal to describe us then. We were obsessed with morning coffee runs and especially only taking small sips out of our cups so the coffee lasted the whole day. What made this all possible was the fact that we got our driver's license, and it was no secret. The swinging and clanking of lanyards with way too many keychains was heard all around the building. And please don't forget the yells of skskskss after someone dropped their hydro flask on the floor, usually giving the teacher a panic attack. Miss Lemon. So yeah, we weren't normal, but I will give us credit for getting through chemistry. We studied chemical reactions, stoichiometry, and were utterly confused at how many significant figures were supposed to be in our final answers. When Miss Lemon introduced us to stoichiometry, it felt like my brain could not even function. How was I ever supposed to remember all of these complicated conversions? I quickly realized that there was no way I could force myself to understand. So I said to myself that I would try to understand by practicing. And with the help of various practice problems and printed out worksheets, my brain could finally wrap around the topic. In high school, we often expect ourselves to be good at things the first time we try them. And if we aren't, we give up. But we have to understand that learning new things takes time. Think of your first sports practice or your first music lesson. I'm sure you have gained new skills since then. Learning something new starts with your intention to just try, not with the expectation that you will already be a master at it. So don't let the question of time inhibit you from doing something that you could possibly love. Now to junior year, the year beginning the everlasting college talks. We slept less, complained more, and wore hoods over our heads to cover up our greasy hair. We came in during our late starts to bubble in our personal information for whichever standardized test we were taking next. On the day of the ACT, we scrambled to find the number two pencils at the bottom of our backpacks, still unsure whether or not the big mechanical pencils we all had would be accepted. Nothing would compare to the immense joy we felt when a Quizlet link popped up in our email. Finally, someone had converted the anatomy study guide into convenient digital flashcards. And when we started getting excited to be seniors, everything changed. And now we were in this thing called quarantine. Instead of flipping through the pages of Don Quixote with my Spanish 3 class, I was left to read the online version on my own. I missed how we would look at each other in shock or burst into laughter when Senor Regan translated the text and we could finally understand how crazy the book was. We missed sitting by the lockers in the morning and talking about how late we stayed up the night before. We missed peeking in each other's lunchboxes and taking the Cheez-Its out before our friends even had the chance to notice. We missed how Miss O would answer questions at the end of anatomy class like, why do we have hair in our noses? Or why do we get goosebumps? We missed the subtle sound of the Beatles playing in Mr. Sparrow's psychology class as we did our group projects. And so, in the midst of our reminiscing, we learned to be grateful. We learned to be grateful for the big things, like spending more time with our families and having access to food and a home. But we also learned to be grateful for the small things too, like how the teachers made special Google Meets to answer questions, or how our friends dropped off little treats at our doors to let us know that they were thinking of us. In the future, I pray we stay grateful. I pray we never forget how the world flipped upside down and how we learn to appreciate things that we have while we still have them. Senior year. This year was filled with brand new ideas and creations. We were really the guinea pigs this year. The beeps of the thermometers welcomed us into the building, plus the groans when they frequently displayed LO in all capitals, and we had to shuffle up to Mr. Marshall to get our temperatures taken a second time. Everything was different this year. Masks covered our faces, no lunch in the cafeteria, no lockers, longer class periods, no more late starts. Even though we were disappointed over the things we couldn't do, we were glad that events like Stang Symposium, Senior Week, Kairos, pep rallies, the dinner dance, and graduation were adapted so we could still experience senior year. This year, it hit me how incredible our teachers are. They're completely dedicated to helping us in any way that they can, and they have been working tirelessly to make this year a good one despite the circumstances. Like how Ms. Ruffalo ran into the student council meetings with new ideas for senior events because she wanted us to spend as much time together as possible. When I was quarantined, Ms. Bardeen recorded a video of the whole class period just for me so I wouldn't get behind. Or how Ms. Beneke, Ms. Brown, and Mr. Hall walked back and forth from K-12 every day so we could have a bigger space with all of our necessary art materials. Or how Mr. Dillon always includes the distance learners in our class discussions, even though he is sometimes met with someone saying they can't answer a question due to technical difficulties. They really do love us. Teachers, I'm sorry if it took too long for us to realize that you are our motivators, our inspirations, our therapists, our friends, and our biggest cheerleaders. So thank you. I can only hope that we have reciprocated the love that you have shown us. As for the parents and family members who helped raise us, we know it was no easy task. You listened to our presentations and clapped afterward, even though we messed up 1,000 times. You stuck our report cards on the fridge and cried after our capstone presentations. You looked over our papers and listened to us complain about our long school days. You gave us everything, and we are eternally grateful. This is your celebration as much as it is ours. One day in health class, Ms. Dozer taught us about CPR. The first thing she said was that you don't give CPR to just any unconscious person. You have to check if they have a pulse. If they don't, you can start compressions. The next step is to attach a defibrillator, which sends electric shocks to the heart. We have had many electric shocks throughout these 4 years, studying for exams, struggling with mental health, healing from loss, going through breakups, dealing with COVID-19. But the thing about restarting a heart is that the electric shocks don't harden the heart. They actually make it beat stronger. The outside world will continue to deliver shocks to our hearts, some harder than others, but the world cannot harden you. Someday, we will all come back to 505 South Ludlow Street, ready to share our new passions, stories, adventures, and experiences. Although we may be different, our hearts will be the same. Tonight, the class of 2021 graduates with the strongest, most resilient hearts the school has ever seen. And as we remember our time here at CJ, we are sure that we grew up here, experienced life here, and most importantly, learned to love here too.
I now invite Kelly Kinnear, the Director of Ministry and Service, to come to the microphone to introduce the next special part of our ceremony. Mrs. Kinnear.
Good evening, class of 2021. I invite you to find your blue or green candle that was placed under your chairs, and please stand, but do not light your candles yet. Within each of us burns an eternal flame, which is the ever-present light of Christ in our lives. This light has illuminated the path for the 2021 graduates and will continue to guide them through the rest of their life journeys. Chaminade Julianne, class of 2021, the candles that you have been given symbolize the light of Christ. Some of you may still have the candles from your freshman retreat. That was the first time you came together as a class to pray. At the end of that retreat, you made a ring of light around Emmanuel Church. Tonight, you will again light your candles together as a class. Although each of you will soon be going your separate ways as your life journeys continue, you will always be connected in your hearts. If you stay open to God's great love for you, the light of Christ's love will always shine in your hearts. As you grow in wisdom, the light of Christ will nourish you. As you grow in faith, it will guide you. As you grow in character, it will inspire you. The gift of Christ's love is that it never stops guiding and helping us to become the holy people that we are called to be. This precious gift from God has been shining in every aspect of your lives. When you stumbled, as well as when you conquered the many obstacles in your path, Christ's light shined. When you reached out your hands in service to others, Christ's light shined. When your parents and relatives nurtured, teachers enlightened, and peers accepted, Christ's light shined. When you cried on the shoulders of your friends and laughed at the great times that you shared, Christ's light shined. Tonight, as you stand together as a class, Recognize the light God has given each of you, and then challenge yourselves to accept the responsibility to take the light of Christ's love out into the world and show others how brightly the light of Christ shines in you. Graduates, please light your candles.
Class of 2021, please take your seats. At our baccalaureate masses yesterday, the family and guests in attendance offered our seniors a special blessing as they move on to the next adventure in their lives. On May 10th, The members of the freshman, sophomore, and junior classes likewise blessed the seniors during our special outdoor all-school mass. Tonight, seniors, we ask our teachers and staff members who have encouraged you, challenged you, supported, and as Maya said, loved you, to offer a final blessing. Seniors, please stand now and turn to the back to face your teachers. Teachers and staff members, if you would stand and raise your hands in blessing. Good and gracious God, we thank you for all the blessings that you have given to us through these men and women of the class of 2021. We thank you for the curiosity, compassion, leadership, and service they have shown during their years at CJ. And we thank you for their perseverance, grace, and resilience throughout this most unusual year. Bless these graduates as they leave the hallways of CJ. Continue to guide them, protect them, and inspire them as they grow in wisdom, knowledge, and grace. Help them to keep the flame of your love burning brightly within them and to share it with all they meet on their life journeys. May they proclaim God's goodness in all they do as they strive to make God and Christ known in the world, carrying with them the spirit of St. Julie and Blessed Chaminade. May they never forget that Chaminade Julienne will always be a place where they will find people who will welcome them home. And may they now and forever soar on eagle's wings. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Seniors, you can turn around. Graduates, no longer seniors, graduates. In a moment, our newest graduates will follow Mr. Muller and me and process from the arena. We ask that you allow them to exit before joining them outside for hugs and photos. And now, our newest alumni will recess to the tune of the Chaminade Julienne Alma Mater.